माइसेल्फ मिस तेजश्री कोसबे, लेक्चरर फ्रॉम प्रवीण पाटिल पॉलिटेक्निक भाईंदर। माई सब्जेक्ट इज मेंटेनेंस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल इक्विपमेंट एंड दिस चैप्टर टू इज मेंटेनेंस शेड्यूल पार्ट थ्री लर्निंग आउटकम्स। एट द एंड ऑफ दिस वीडियो यू विल लर्न अबाउट फैक्टर्स अफेक्टिंग लाइफ ऑफ ट्रांसफॉर्मर। सो वॉट आर द फैक्टर्स अफेक्टिंग लाइफ ऑफ ट्रांसफॉर्मर? इन द फर्स्ट फैक्टर इज मॉइस्चर, सेकेंड इज सॉलिड इम्प्योरिटीज, थर्ड इज वॉर्निशेस, फोर्थ प्रेजेंस ऑफ ऑक्सीजन, फिफ्थ इज स्टैकनेस ऑफ वाइंडिंग एंड सिक्स्थ इज टेम्परेचर। सो फर्स्ट वन मॉइस्चर। जनरली द ट्रांसफॉर्मर कोर एंड वाइंडिंग असेंबली इज अकोमोडेटेड इन द टैंक विच इज फुल ऑफ ट्रांसफॉर्मर ऑयल। इफ मॉइस्चर कम्स इन कॉन्टैक्ट विद द ऑयल देन डाइलेक्ट्रिक स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द ऑयल रिड्यूसेस। Through oil, the moisture comes in contact with the insulation of the windings and it will be absorbed by the insulation and this will reduce the insulation strength. To avoid this, a breather is provided which absorbs moisture, dust, etc. prior to enter in the tank. So, silica gel is filled up in breather. And when this silica gel changes its color, then you can observe the presence of moisture. Solid impurities. Generally, the filtered oil is filled in the transformer tank. If the tank is not clean and it contains solid particles inside, then this will get mixed with the oil and dielectric strength of the oil is reduced. To avoid this, see that the tank is clean prior to filling it with filtered oil. Next is varnishes. Sometimes there is a chemical reaction of varnish and transformer oil from the slug at a faster rate. This reduces dielectric strength, so do not use such varnish. Presence of oxygen. Oxygen forms slug in the oil, which creates obstacles in the oil circulation. If free circulation of oil is obstructed, then cooling becomes ineffective, raising the temperature. Take at utmost care which while filling the filtered oil in the tank, then tank is completely evacuated to expel the air in it which contains oxygenate. Next one is temperature. All the insulations are sensitive to temperatures. There are so many insulations used in transformer, such as transformer oil, varnish, winding, enameling, insulation, etc. Transformer's life depends on height of insulations. So increase the working temperature by 1 degree Celsius, transformer's life reduces by 10%. So temperature is also the main factor. Next is stackness of winding. Positions of the coil are disturbed and the coils are stacked due to the following reasons. First is short circuit, second electromagnetic forces, third is electrostatic forces, and fourth is alternate heating and cooling of coils. Lift up the core coil assembly and see that tie rods are not loose and tighten the rods to remove stacking. Next topic is maintenance schedule for transformer capacities less than 1000 kVA. So this is the maintenance schedule for transformer. The first one is inspection frequency. That is, you can do the maintenance for hourly basis. So first is hourly. Items to be inspected, that is for hourly basis, you can inspect load, that is current, inspection notes, check against rated figures, and action required if inspection shows unsatisfactory condition is need for the first. Second, inspection frequency is hourly. Items to be inspected for this: voltage, inspection notes, check against rated figures, and action required is nil. Third is for daily basis you have to check dehydrating breather. An inspection notes, check that air passages are clear. Check color of active agent, that is silica gel. If silica gel is pink, change by spare charge. The old charge may be reactivated for use again. So for daily basis, you have to check breather, that is silica gel and its color. Fourth point is, for monthly basis, you have to check oil level in transformer. So inspection notes are, check oil level in transformer and action required. If low, if the level is low, then top up with dry oil, examine transformer for leaks. Then for quarterly basis, you have to check bushings, examine for cracks and dirt deposits. If this happens, then you have to clean or replace it. Then for half yearly basis, you have to check non-conservator transformer. So check for moisture undercover. An action required for this is improve ventilation and check oil. For yearly basis, you have to check oil in transformer. So for check for dielectric strength and water content, check for acidity and sludge. Then action required, take suitable action to restore quality of oil. So next, yearly basis, you have to check earth resistance. Action required are, take suitable actions if earth resistance is high. So earth resistance should be as low as possible. So you have to check earth resistance on yearly basis. Next, on yearly basis, you have to check relays, alarms and their circuit. Examine relay and alarm contacts, their operation, uses, etc. Check relay accuracy, etc. An action required for this are, clean the components and replace contacts and fuses if necessary. Change the setting if necessary. On 2 yearly basis, you have to check non-conservator, internal inspection above core. Action required, filter the oil regardless of condition. On 5 yearly basis, you have to inspect overall inspection including lifting of core and coils and wash by housing down with clean dry oil. So on 5 yearly basis, you have to remove the windings from the transformer and core and fill the fresh oil in the transformer tank. Next is maintenance schedule for transformer of capacity greater than 1000 kVA. For this, on hourly basis, you have to check ambient temperature and winding temperature. So check that temperature rise is reasonable. Shut down the transformer and investigate if either is persistently higher than normal. So if the temperature rise is higher, then you have to shut down the transformer and investigate the cause. Next, on hourly basis, you have to check oil temperature and load, that is in ampere, that is current, you have to check. Check against rated figures, and on hourly basis you have to also check voltage. So check against the rated figures also. On daily basis, you have to check oil level in transformer. Check against transformer oil level. If the level is low, you have to top up with dry oil. Examine transformer for leakage. On daily basis, you have to check oil level in bushing, leakage of water into cooler and relief diaphragm. So if the diaphragm is cracked, then you have to replace it. On daily basis, you have to also check dehydrating breather. So check that air passages are free. Check colors of active agent, that is silica gel. So if silica gel is pink, change by spare charge. The old charge may be reactivated for use again.
On quarterly basis, you have to check bushing, examine for cracks and dirt deposits. If there is crack or dirt, then you have to clean and replace it. On quarterly basis, you have to check oiling transformer, check for dielectric strength and water content. Take suitable action to restore quality of oil. On quarterly basis, you have to also check cooler fan bearings, motors and operating mechanism. Lubricate bearings, check gearbox, examine contacts, check manual control and interlocks. Action required are replace burnt or worn contacts or other parts. On half yearly basis, you have to check oil cooler, test it for pressure. On yearly basis, you have to check oil in transformer, check for acidity and sludge. And if there is acid or sludge in it, then you have to filter it and replace it. On yearly basis, you have to check oil filled bushing. So test oil in bushing and filter it or replace it. On yearly basis, you have to check gasket joints. Action required for this are tighten the bolts evenly to avoid uneven pressure. On 2 yearly basis, you have to check cable boxes, check for sealing arrangements, for filling holes, examine compound for cracks. And if there is cracks, then you have to replace the gasket if leaking. 2 yearly basis, you have to check surge diverter and gaps, examine for cracks and dirt deposits. And if there are dirt deposits, then you have to clean for replace. On 2 yearly basis, you have to check relays, alarms, their contacts, etc. So examine relay and alarm contacts, their operation, fuses, etc. Check relay accuracy, etc. And action required for these are clear the components and replace contacts and fuses if necessary. Change the setting if necessary. On 2 yearly basis, you have to check earth resistance. And if the earth resistance is high, then you have to take the suitable action. 5 yearly basis, 1000 to 3000 kVA transformer, you have to do overall inspection including lifting of core and coils, wash by housing down with clean dry oil. And for 7 to 10 yearly basis, for transformer above 3000 kVA, overall inspection including lifting of core and coils and wash by hosing down with clean dry oil. So for 5 yearly or 7 to 10 yearly basis, you have to inspect all the parts of the transformer